covered the eye and vision. We've got two more senses left. We've got the taste and the smell. Both of these kind of go together, and they're not super complicated, which is why we are learning them today. This will be the last section of notes for the semester, and then tomorrow will be your test, and then on Thursday and Friday, we will jump right into preparing for your final.
Yay!
Means that the semester is almost over.
Oh, mistake. We only got one more.
All right, there you go. Just making sure it worked.
No, really?
Shut up.
All right, so chemoreceptors. We've talked about thermoreceptors and mechanoreceptors. Well, now we're talking about chemoreceptors. Mechanoreceptors are stimulated by some kind of outside force. Thermoreceptors detect hot or cold, while chemoreceptors detect chemicals. They're stimulated by some kind of chemical. Taste has five types of receptors, and smell can differentiate a wider range of chemicals. Both taste and smell complement each other and respond to many of the same stimuli. So if you smell something, like if you're hungry and you smell something, your body can detect that, and it makes your mouth water. It's kind of the two senses, smell and taste, really do kind of go together. If you are tasting something and you can smell it at the same time, then it makes the process more enjoyable. If you have to take some nasty medicine that doesn't taste very good, then hold your nose as you swallow it and you won't taste it as much.
Going to interpret smell.
There's a big nerve that runs to that area and lots of nerve extensions. That's where the smell is going to be interpreted. This is a Google Classroom, and again, anything in red, you will need to identify. I'm not expecting you to know too much for this. The olfactory bulb, olfactory filaments, and olfactory nerve, olfactory hairs. So those are pretty simple terms for identification. I'm not expecting you to get super in-depth with them. Any questions about smell? Pretty simple. The smell comes in the air, little tiny particles. They hit the receptors at the top of the nose. They mix with the mucus that is there. Those receptors send it to the brain. Brain interprets it. Taste is pretty simple too. Taste buds house the receptor organs. So the taste buds have the taste receptors inside them. Most of them are on the tongue. There's a few like taste receptors on the cheek and on like the inner portion of the lips, maybe on the roof of the mouth, but most of the taste receptors are on the tongue. The soft palate of the mouth, you have a soft and a hard palate. So obviously if you feel like the roof of your mouth, there's a hard portion. If you put your tongue further back, you can feel the soft portion. So the soft palate at the back of the mouth has a few taste receptors. Around. does is it sticks its tongue out, it gathers the chemical on its tongue, pulls it in its mouth, and sticks it up in what's called the Jacobson organ on the roof of the mouth, and interprets it. So it's kind of like a combination of tasting and smelling the air. There are also some animals like cats that will kind of pull their teeth back and kind of inhale through their mouth, and that's because they have a structure kind of like the Jacobson mm-hmm. organ on the top of their mouth that will detect chemicals from the air. Alright, so here are some other examples. Again, you need to know the stuff in red. There's not a lot of labeling for this. You've got to taste the bud, which is the whole thing, a gustatory cell, which is inside the taste bud, and then you've got the gustatory hairs, which is on the surface. So you actually have little tiny hairs on your mouth.
You need Olivia, too.
Olivia. Ions, and bitter detects like alkaloid ions. Salty detects metal, and umami responds to that specific amino acids. We didn't talk too much about amino acids, but amino acids make up the proteins. And so when you break down a protein, you break it down into different amino acids.
Because you just break the red. You don't run out the red.
Started going really bad when I started getting
pregnant. Because the baby starts taking nutrients from stuff like that.
The baby's a little parasite. It will take whatever it wants from the mother.
Yeah, so you're
whatever it needs.
No, that's a big fear of mine.
Parents that literally don't know they're pregnant until they're having their baby.
Those people often have a medical condition that makes it so that their periods are irregular. And so for them, going a couple months without a period is a normal thing. But sometimes they're heavier set too. So when the baby grows, they don't even notice. If the placenta is toward the stomach, then when the baby kicks and moves, it kicks the placenta instead of the mother. So the mother might not feel it. It's like the baby's kicking a pillow. So there is a lot of things that would have to kind of fall in place for that to happen.
I don't even know if I'm going to get pregnant. I might just adopt.
I loved it. I loved having babies.
There's a lot of kids on the market.
No adoption. They need homes too.
My nephew was Alright, so taste and smell are most acute at birth and decrease in sensitivity after the age of 40. So babies can detect flavors and taste sensations, even in the womb. They can taste the food that the mother is eating because it makes the amniotic fluid taste differently. So I'm kind of a picky eater, and two of the four children are kind of picky eaters too. And it's like, well, I wonder if it was because of me, because when I was pregnant, I was kind of picky eater. I had morning sickness. I didn't eat much. So maybe they got their pickiness from me. I don't know, but they can taste different sensations as early as the womb, and after they're born, they can taste as well. Which is why it's kind of sad that one of the first foods, like real foods you introduce, is this really bland, like rice cereal, and it tastes really bad.
Ew.
Like, honestly, my kids never did
baby
bites.
Exactly.
Like the blueberry.
Yes.
Rice.
The sooner you can get babies off of baby food into regular food, the better. So my babies never did baby food, not maybe a month or two. Thursday and Friday. Questions?
Well, we need to know if you're